You are welcome to Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. This is Daylight Magazine. Welcome, my wonderful listener, to Children's Hour. Today, we have a wonderful package for you, and God will surely bless you if you stay tuned in to the end of this program. I am your presenter, Alfred Balisasa. Stay with us, for your blessing is on the way. You are tuned into Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope.
Voice of Hope.
This is Daylight Magazine. On today's program, we have
Story Time,
Memory Verses, Life Songs, and Moments of Truth.
AWR, Voice of Hope, we will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
Lesson 10, Memory Verse, The First Christmas. Thank thee to God for his gifts. 2 Corinthians 9 verse 15. The Message. We worship God when we thank him for sending Jesus to us. Amen.
Lesson 1, Past Points. We follow Jesus when we help others in the sight of others. Practice. With the help of our God, we then to tell you his gospel in the spite of opposition. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 2. Amen.
Lesson 4, PowerPoint. We serve others by telling them what Jesus means to us. Power test. I consider my work nothing to me, if only I may finish the race and complete the task of testifying. The task of testifying to the gospel of God's grace. Acts chapter 20, verse 24. Amen.
Lesson 2, Peter kept your past. Let me say, I will take, and you look after me. Matthew 25, 36, the best is, we care for some healthy people. Amen.
Lesson 10, PowerPoint. We worship God when we trust his plan for our life. Power test. Let the morning bring me word of your unfailing love, for I have put my trust in you. Show me the way I should go, for to you I lift up my soul. Psalm 143 verse 8. Amen.
Lesson 1, Wake up, little girl. Memory verse. I pray that you may enjoy good health. Lesson verse 2, The Message. We serve God when we pray for the sick. Amen.
Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR, Voice of Hope. We will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
Stay tuned in while we present to you
Story Time,
Live Songs, and Moments of Truth.
Welcome, listeners, to today's edition of Storytime. I'm Emmanuel Atechi, and the story I'm about to tell you or share with you is God Chooses Mary. About 5 months later, the angel Gabriel was sent to earth. He was sent to a woman named Mary in a town named Nazareth in the northern part of Galilee. Nazareth did not have good reputation. The people there were said to be impolite and rough. They were disrespected because they never obeyed what they were told to do. But Mary and Joseph were very different. They were polite, they respected, and you can think of all good qualities of a good person. Joseph was a hard-working carpenter. He loved Mary and was engaged to her. As soon as he had prepared everything for their wedding, Joseph was ready to marry her and bring her to his home. When the angel entered Mary's room, she was very scared and afraid. but he spoke to her in a friendly manner. "Hello, Mary," the angel said. "God has chosen you to do a very special and great task." Mary was quite confused. She was so absurd and she didn't know what to do. "What was this supposed to mean?" she asked herself in a quiet manner. "You do not need to be afraid. God loves you and he will give you everything you need. You will become pregnant and bring a son into the world. You are to name him Jesus, for he is the Son of God, and he will be made a king to rule over the earth forever." Mary knew that this Son of God was the promised Savior, and she was to be his mother. "How is this going to happen? I have never slept with any man, and I'm a virgin," Mary said in amazement. "The Holy Ghost will do it," the angel Gabriel explained. "God's power will make the promised child within you. Therefore, this holy child will also be called God's Son." Mary nodded. She could neither imagine this miracle nor understand it, but she trusted God very much. Then the angel continued, "Your relative Elizabeth is also having a son." Again, Mary was completely amazed because she thought that Elizabeth was too old to bear any more children. She has already been pregnant for 6 months. Even though everyone claimed she was barren, she could never have a child. The angel smiled as he looked at Mary's wide eyes. "God can do everything. Nothing is impossible for him because he is the Messiah and he can do everything you need." After a moment, Mary replied to the heavenly messenger, "I belong to God and I know that whatever he has said may come to pass." Then the angel said goodbye to her and disappeared. She kept thinking about the things that the angel had told her. She would have a baby soon. This was so amazing and so wonderful. Then Mary heard that Elizabeth was going to have a baby. This was even more than her imagination. She packed some clothes, took some round flat loaves and a handful of dates for provisions, and decided to go to Elizabeth's house right away. Then she set off. Perhaps she marched through mountains and over hills completely alone. We are not sure, but one thing remains clear. She did not take long breaks, for she was in great hurry to see Elizabeth. Mary was surely the best of all women in Israel, and this is why God chose her to be the Savior's mother. Mary was granted this great, great privilege, but it was also a great responsibility. Her humility and obedience to the Lord is an excellent example for all of us here. We must always believe, we must always be obedient, and we must always do as God says we should do. We must never doubt anything that we are told to do. We must always be like Mary, because we don't know when we are going to be given a great purpose such as this. I know you enjoyed this lesson very much. Hope you stay tuned for the next edition of this story time. Bye!
You have been listening to Daylight Magazine coming from Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. If you need further information or study materials on issues we have discussed, please contact us on Adventist World Radio Ghana, VVU PO Box AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through awr@vvu.edu.gh, or better still, you can call us on 233-20-8704532. The number again, 233-20-8704532. If our line is busy, don't give up trying, for we are expecting your calls, emails, and letters.
AWR, Voice of Hope. We will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
It is time to enjoy a life song.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Let such as love your salvation.
Your salvation.
She continually. Let such as love your salvation.
Say.
And be glad in you.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Let such as love your salvation.
Your salvation.
She continually. Let such as love your salvation.
Say.
Seek you, rejoice and be glad in you. Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Oh yeah!
In you.
Let such as love your salvation.
Your salvation.
Continually. Let such as love your salvation.
It is time to listen to the Word of God. Stay tuned in while we present to you Moments of Truth.
Calling for you and for me.
Calling for you and me.
See on the portal, He's waiting and watching. Watching for you.
Once again, welcome to Moment of Truth. You know, one day Jesus Christ was walking with his disciples and he said to them, "Friends, if you love me, keep my commandments." Jesus' love is so overwhelming and he invites us to have this kind of love. Today, our topic under discussion is, I am sure it is love. But before we go to that, I want to remind you that the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Jesus, the Son of God, is the only Savior of the world. Without Him, you will perish. But when you have Him, you know you will definitely have life. Not just life, but life that is eternal. Satan has never stopped quoting the Bible or scriptures, if you may put it that way. And so therefore, don't stop studying your Bible. If you do so, you will be able to overcome him, the devil. And you will have 100% success in life. You will never fail. And heaven will be rest assured for you. That is when you practice the words therein. Amen. Can we have a word of prayer? Father, today we elogize your name. Oh, Father, we come to you in our hopelessness state. We come to you, O God, in our sinfulness state. We pray that you will sanctify your children. Even God, as I am about to undertake this difficult task of preaching, I pray that you will sanctify me. And may you speak your words through me, O dear Lord. And may others hear your words, not mine. In Jesus' name, amen. Our subject under discussion is, I am sure it's love. You know, so many people are not sure about what love truly is. You know, the word love is ambiguous. Its ambiguity is in many folds. We have true love and false love. But how is someone able to know that this is surely love? Someone has said that true love doesn't have a happy ending. True love doesn't have an ending. In other words, true love is enduring. It can weather the stress and strains of old age, adversity, hurt, and even disappointment. And I'm going to let something be plain before you, and you will know that it is surely love. Oh, I know it is surely love. I am sure it is love, not because of its shining hair, nor the skin smooth and fair, but for its character so rare. Oh, I am sure it's love, 'cause its worth is more than Ghana's gold. Its strength far exceeds Samson's hold. Its wisdom beyond what Solomon told. I am sure it's love, 'cause in the years that have gone, despite grinding trials, it has borne. Its luster of patience has brightly shone. Oh, I am sure it is love, 'cause for each day of reflection, there is an ample time of affection about God's plan and direction. Oh, I am sure it is love, 'cause it gives everything without expecting anything. I am sure it is love, and even willing to be nothing. I am sure it is love, for when life's storms appear, it's near to calm and cheer, to stir my faith, to persevere. I am sure it is love, 'cause when there is a mistake, my heart does not quake. I am sure it is love, for fear our relation will break. Oh, I am sure it is love, 'cause when I give cause for it to lose, it never forgets its sacred oath. Before the Lord between us both, oh, I am sure it is love, for it knows not mine or thine. Since our lives do now entwine or are together, and selfless giving is there to shine. Oh, I am sure it is love, 'cause in rainy or sunny weather, we strive to grow together, bearing fruit for each other. I am sure it is love, for when to paths of death I stray, it calls me back to God's straight way and walks with me to his home to stay. I am sure it is love. You are sure it is love, my friend. And the only person you can sort that kind of love is the man whose name is Jesus Christ. He will never leave you nor forsake you, my brother, my sister. You know it is love. And this kind of love is being put in Christians who will give their hearts and minds to Jesus Christ. And so know when you are really loving or somebody is truly loving you, you know it is love and you are sure it is love. May God bless you mightily and increasingly. Let your will be placed in the hands of Jesus Christ, and your life will never be the same. May he bless you abundantly. In his name have I prayed. Amen. Your brother, Ezekiel, will say, as
tune in to Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. This is Daylight Magazine.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. You have been listening to Daylight Magazine, coming from Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. If you need further information or study materials on issues we have discussed, please contact us on Adventist World Radio Ghana, VVUP Box AF595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through awr@vvu.edu.gh. Or better still, you can call us on 233-20-8704532. The number again, 233-20-8704532. If our line is busy, don't give up trying, for we are expecting your calls, emails, and letters. Today's program was presented by Alfred Balisasa. May God bless you.